Hello, in this video we will show how to use a StickToSurface node to convert a few dozen blend shapes from one topology to another. In today's example, we are going to use 45 blend shapes of an actor that were produced by wrapping the same topology onto a set of scans of the actor's expressions. Imagine that we decided to modify the topology or completely change it to the MetaHuman topology later in production. We will show you how you can propagate these changes across all models automatically. So we will go from this to this in just a few minutes. Let me start by loading a neutral mesh. Then let me load all the blend shapes we made previously. All these blend shapes have the same topology as the neutral mesh. If we were to rewrap all 45 meshes to the MetaHuman topology, it would take too much time and would probably add inconsistencies between the meshes. We will show you how to match the source and the target topology once and propagate these changes across all the models automatically. Let me load our target topology. In this case, I'm going to use the MetaHuman base mesh. By default, a MetaHuman mesh has a texture that portrays guidelines of major facial features like eyebrows, nasolabial folds, lip contours, etc. First of all, we need to match our target topology mesh with a neutral mesh as the source topology. To do that, we will use a fast wrapping node. Our MetaHuman mesh goes into the first input. Our neutral mesh goes into the second input. Let me click the compute button. The fast wrapping node automatically wrapped the MetaHuman mesh onto our neutral mesh. Then let me add a sticked surface node. Let me plug the fast wrapping result into the first input, the corresponding neutral mesh into the second input, and our target blend shapes that we want to convert into the MetaHuman topology goes into the third input. Now I'll translate the original blend shape a little bit so we can see it side by side with the sticked surface result. This is how we can convert any blend shape into the MetaHuman topology. As I switch to the next blend shape, the conversion is done automatically. But if we zoom into the lips and eyelids, you can see noticeable artifacts on the mesh. To fix that, we need to provide a more accurate mapping between the topologies. Instead of wrapping the mesh onto a neutral face, we're going to use an expression with the mouth half open and the eyelids half closed. This will give us full control over mesh correspondences. Let me select these nodes and delete them. Now I will select a suitable facial expression from our set of blend shapes. This expression should work well. As you can see, the mouth is wide open and the eyes are fully closed. We can slightly modify it by using a mixed geom node. But first, let me copy the path name of this exact mesh. Now I'll create a load geom node, rename it to jaw open blink, and paste the path name. Now I'll create a mixed geom node in order to blend the neutral mesh and the jaw open mesh. I will blend it at 50%. And this is how a target geometry for wrapping should look like. This time I'm going to use a cartoon wrapping node because it produces fewer artifacts on large mesh deformations. Into the first input goes our MetaHuman. Then we input our target blend shape. For a more accurate wrapping, let's provide point correspondences. To do that, let me create a select points pairs node. I will plug the MetaHuman into the first input and our mixed geom results into the second input. I will enable the sync views option. Now let me select a few matching points between these two meshes. For the sake of time, let me skip the selection of the rest of the points and return to you when everything is ready. So after we've selected all the point correspondences, let's plug them into the cartoon wrapping node and click the compute button. And after a few seconds, we have our wrap result. The mesh has some artifacts on the eyelids and the mouth corners. Let's fix it with a brush node. Let me plug our wrapping result into the first input, our target geometry into the second, and the original MetaHuman mesh into the third. I'll enable the Use Geodesic Distance option and change the symmetry to topological. Let me start by fixing the intersections on the eyelids using the Relax brush. As you can see, after using the Relax brush, some vertices are no longer located on the surface of the target mesh. To fix that, I will use the Relax project brush. Let me turn off the topological symmetry. Now we'll use the clone brush to fix the artifacts on the outer eyelids. Let's do the same for the other eye. The clone brush fixes artifacts by copying the surface from our MetaHuman mesh. With this done, let's move on to the corners of the mouth. In this case, let's use the Relax project brush to fix these artifacts. Let me also fix the inner part of the mouth. I will also smooth the other corner. Also, I will use the Move Project brush to slightly modify the polygon flow on the inner parts of the lips. Now we can press the Accept button. Now let me add a StickToSurface node, and I'll repeat the process I showed you earlier, but in this case we'll use a half-open mouth mesh instead of a neutral one. I will plug our newly created mesh with the MetaHuman topology into the first input. I'll plug the same model with the source topology into the second input, and the current blend shape into the third input. And now if we switch between the frames, you can see that the node converts our blend shapes into the MetaHuman topology perfectly. Now let's create a save geom node to store our results. A simple way to preserve the same names for save files is to go to the load geom node and copy this Python expression. Let's paste it into the expression editor of the save geom node. Let me add the _ MetaHuman topology suffix to the folder name and click save. And if we click the compute frame range button, it will automatically convert all 45 meshes. So that's it for this tutorial. I hope you liked it. See you in the next video.